the last week as a team, we were talking about 2 Corinthians, and Paul says in 2 Corinthians that we are like treasures in jars of clay. Jars of clay are really easily vulnerable and cracked and broken. From this, I was learning that God's power is inside of us, and that even though we are cracked and broken as human beings, we can shine the light of God through our cracks, and we're not called to be perfect, but even when we are weak, God's power shines through us. So it's just like this jar. It has holes inside of it, but when you have water or something inside, it can pass through, just like this light.
Hey! Today, we are going to cook brigadeiro.
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 Brigadeiro. Brigadeiro.
It's awesome. As you can see, here. Oh, and we are going to read the Bible while do that, because you can do two things at the same time, right? Come on, hello.
And the ingredients are condensed milk, 100% cacao powder, salt, a pen, an egg, the Bible, butter, how you imagine, and how it is, dark chocolate, notebook, pens and highlighters. Okay, first step, open things. Open this and this. Our text is 2 Corinthians 4. 7-9.
But we have this treasure in jars of clay to show that this all-surpassing power is from God and not from us. We are hard-pressed on every side, but not crushed, perplexed, but not in despair, persecuted, but not abandoned, struck down, but not destroyed.
So now we do context. You can research about the writer, the reason behind it. Now put both condensed milk cans in the pan, only one egg, a tablespoon of salt, 2 tablespoons of cacao powder. I know it's bitter, but I like it because it breaks the sweetness of the condensed milk. A little bit like that of butter. That a third? I don't know. Time to heat it up. Careful, kids, please. Call your parents and spark, please. Oh yeah, never stop mixing. I said don't stop. Now it's too liquid, and the famous brigadeiro point is when you draw away in the pan with your spoon and it takes a while to close.
So, I found out that Paul wrote most of the letters, but in 2 Corinthians he was a co-writer with Timothy. Yay! And the theme of the letter is...
find out.
Now, put the brigadeiro on a plate. Some people eat like this, but we are not. Let it cool down and let's do connections. With connections, I mean finding another Bible passage which connects with what we're studying now.
My connection was a song by Hillsong called Everlasting, and it was because of its chorus.
And now put the brigadeiro in the fridge. If there's any space left on it, I think you don't have space enough. Let's talk about toppings. You can buy in the supermarket, but I like to make it.
So I'm drawing dragons, grating chocolate. You do dresh, and dresh is when you put your feet in the character's feet. But you say, Sarah, but our story doesn't have a character. Oh boy. I'm gonna show you.
I drew this broken vase and a normal one to represent who I am. Okay, back to treasure. This is the best part when we roll the brigadeiros. A wee bit of butter in your hand so it won't stick. A wee bit of brigadeiro and a lot of topping to cover it all. Now is the time when we let God speak to us. While Ned enjoyed this amazing brigadeiro, I will go to my favorite spot, not to pray, not to read the Bible, in silence. Open space to God talk to me. Yeah, That's it. If you liked it, don't forget to give your thumbs up.
Welcome to the Flying Whistle. Today, we have an update for you about the flood in East Belfast. Yeah, Sarah and Annette are not allowed to go out like no one, and they have to live and to work there together, and it's really exhausting. But also, all our families are not allowed to go out like you guys. And we want to encourage you that we have still fun. So try to do challenges or something you ever wanted to do, because you have a lot of time right now and you will never have so much time again.